Hey guys, and welcome back to Let's Play Panzer Corps 2. This is the Spanish Civil War, the battle for Madrid in 1939. We have a sizable battle group in the south and also in the north. And meanwhile, we let the Republicans and the Communists fight amongst themselves. And that is working out pretty well. I guess we need to cross this river soon, because most of the troops are on the east bank of the river, mostly communists here. I am guessing that when we cross, some of their attention will be directed towards us. So let's maybe wait and let these guys here finish each other off. In the southwest corner, we are occupying this airfield. The communists also have an airfield here. We can move in. They have a 2 T-26, a BA-6 and a BT-5 in this area. I'll keep the armored units out of the inner city. And maybe we can do something here. Let's see. No anti-air. We have the Verdeja and Breda, one Breda unit and a T-26. Also have the scout, can do some damage. T-26 gone. You have a lot of infantry here. They can guard the bridge. Can we get to the airfield? No. Right, should have used the bomber. Slowly advance the infantry. Park the bridging engineers on the bridge. And in this corner, light anti-air here. Scout. This Stuka doesn't have support. Still some Republican forces here. I think the communists will focus on them. We can set up here to protect the Stuka. Provide anti-tank support. Don't think it is really needed here, but just in case. And we can also cross the river here, of course. Let's work towards the bridge and also move up the bridging engineers to create a second crossing, maybe. Well, still have a fighter available to protect the Stuka. But it's covered by the 88. So we can stay where they are. Same for the rest of the map. Yeah, the Republicans need some help. Anti-tank. Scout. Well, the entire city is visible. Just give the enemy air force a target, maybe. Or keep them at the base. Still have this bomber. Have the Messerschmitt right here, so no targets available, and we do not have air superiority, so let's be careful. Maybe send out these cavalry troops to link up with our troops here. That's it for the turn. A lot of the troops encircled. AT units destroyed. And the Republicans seem to be on the losing side. So this tank took quite some damage. Let's take this airfield. Maybe overrun. Let's keep it here as a target for the Guardia Civil. This tank. Only bombers. Send out the scouts. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's take this part of the city first and then... move east. Base here. Extra protection. Heavy weapons troops. Colonial infantry. Anti-tank support. Right, they are moving towards the river. Took this airfield from the communists. Not sure if they have another airfield. They have three bombers. Can maybe do something here and set up the anti-air. Doesn't quite cover what I needed to cover, so maybe not engage these Stukas. Well, we have one fighter, alright, can do something. Limited range. Need to rebase them, maybe here. Still enemy fighters here though, so let's maybe wait. Still Send out this fighter for protection. Stuka, and we also have this group. Cannot get to that airfield. Let's just park it in a safe position. Same for this bomber. The rest of the troops can stay where they are. We do some repairs. And that's the end of turn 17. 85 of the units that we need to destroy are gone. Suicide attack. They still have that airfield. They did need to rebase, so we'll not see action this turn. Apart from this. Units destroyed. Communists are winning. A few good tanks, several overruns, need the scout plane, check out this area. Very slow going. All right. Can actually move up the Regulares towards this airfield. Can provide support with the Luftwaffe. Might be a idea. Let's try it. They may get targeted by the bombers, but we'll see what happens. artillery. So mostly communist troops. Need to get to this anti-air gun before we can do any bombing here. We have two fighters. Well, we have a fighter here, I think. No targets for this bomber. Cannot provide support. Can take out this PA6. Right. Colonial infantry and cavalry. So now we need to cross the bridge. We have several options, several bridges and the bridging engineers. No range, right, so let's base. fighters. Three Stukas. This is the problem area where we do not have a lot of troops present. We are in the process of maybe recapturing this airfield. This bomber. Let's put it somewhere safe. Near a fighter. Let's keep the artillery protected. Replacement for some of the troops. Need to bomb this area. We can start with that next turn. We also are closing in on the city center with this infantry force. Half of the turns done. 99 units destroyed. End of the turn. Let's quickly check. We have a bomber. No targets. Park it here. And that's it for this turn. Cavalry troops do not have support. I could start here. Zero damage. So cannot really do much on this turn. Can send in the colonial infantry. Guardia Civil. Regulares, right. They volunteered. let's go for an assault. See, we have artillery support here. Move up a bit. Alright, let's send the scout out first. Ambush. Take the airfields. I think the communists are out of airfields. That would mean we can use the bombers freely. Meaning fighter support not necessary anymore. Artillery here and here. Right, to take the bridges. Very good. Take this bridge. And this bridge. replacements for some of the troops. Next turn we can hopefully attack the anti-air gun with some of the infantry. So I'm going to assume air superiority. Zero damage. Now let's keep it at the base. These planes are not useful anymore. Can we get them? Right. And that is it for the turn. Next turn we should be trying to attack this anti-air gun so we can bomb the artillery. Slowly moving in from the north. Still have some Republican forces here, so these guys will continue fighting amongst themselves. And then we need to clear out the inner city of communists. Right, still have a base here. So, no air superiority and we lose a... Almost lost a Stuka. We have one fighter here. Can move towards this airfield. No enemy troops in the area. Two I-16s and a Tupolev. Rebase this plane to a safe position. Take down this I-16. Cannot get into range. The other fighters, we cannot get them close. He could try to take this airfield. I thought I would set up, but let's take the bridge. Replacement. let's maybe not attack these troops. They can fight with the International Brigade. Keep the Regulares where they are. Cannot get to the anti-air gun. Some replacements. Zero damage, wow. Not much to scout, maybe up here. Anti-air gun not destroyed yet. No range on this bomber. We are kind of out of fighters. This is also a bomber. Another bomber. So several bombers still at the base. Let's give the enemy airplanes a few targets. And we are done with this turn. Wow. I think we have a 88 in the area. Right. Let's go for the Tupolev. Very good. Take out the enemy fighter. Now we can just use the bombers whenever we want. This is anti-air. Out. Zero damage, right. I wanted to place the artillery here, but I think it is safe. maybe block this bridge. Anti-tank support. Regulares. These troops need replacements. Wow. All right. Keep it as is. Gave the communists a nice target here. Keep the bridge. Keep the cavalry in the back. Replacements for these troops. Can engage the irregularis, but not now. Too many troops in this area. Two scouts. Luftwaffe engaged almost fully. No targets for this Stuka. That's the end of the turn. First we can take out the Tupolev. Yeah, bombers needed and anti-air gun repaired. Primary target. Thank you. take this airfield. So, enemy air force destroyed. Several tanks. All right. These troops need a replacement. need some infantry here. This is anti-air. Scouts. Yeah, I'll take damage from the anti-air. Move up the heavy weapons. Send out a few. Well, the enemy air force is destroyed, so we could set up this 88 as anti-tank support. Gap here, so maybe dangerous. Let's keep it as is. Or we can put the bridging engineers right here. They stay in the truck. Why do you stay in your truck? Go to anti-tank. That's it for the turn, I think. Units destroyed. The anti-air is repaired again. Let's take it out. Hopefully. Good. Scouting plane. Don't don't need that anymore. Just send out the bombers. We have complete air superiority. Most of the troops in the city are without supplies. No targets. And in the heavy weapons, well, that doesn't really help. More bombing needed here. Placement. Take out this artillery. Let's maybe not move the tanks in the city. Can move up the scouts. Take the objective, do some damage. And retreat. Keep the tank here, maybe. So apparently we only need to destroy 8 more units. Very good. Scouting plane. Still have a bomber. No real targets. Let's redeploy. Closer to the city. Same for these. Scouting plane can stay at the base. That's it for the turn. Remaining, final, remaining 8 units. Targets in range. Yeah, bombers needed here. Set up the heavy weapons. Completely surround them, the remaining. Communists. These units are not supported. End of this turn. Now let's kill these remaining troops. The war is over, right? It was a surprisingly easy battle, as long as you manage to keep the Republicans and Communists fighting amongst themselves in this city area. Keep your tanks and armored vehicles out of the city and just surround it from the north and the south, taking the essential airfields on the go. So that's it for the DLC. With Madrid finally under nationalist control, the total collapse of the Republican faction is complete, except for a few pockets of resistance. All Republican territory now belongs to Franco. The British and French governments have formalized and recognize the nationalist government, and recognition from the United States is only a matter of time. The new nationalist regime is indebted to Germany for our help. We've already acquired some extremely lucrative trade agreements for materials such as tungsten and iron. But for us, after 3 long years of war, we are finally going home. And an urgent message from Sophia. And it's a letter to Stefan. Not going to read all of this, but she wants to thank Stefan and General Snitzel for their help. Well, you're welcome, I guess. Finally bringing some measure of peace to the country of Spain. I don't know how long it will take for things to start feel normal again. So no more sounds of distant cannon fire. With the conflict in Spain finally at an end, she has no interest in the whispers of looming war coming from Europe. And that's the debriefing. And that's the final mission of this DLC. I'll probably make a overall thoughts of the video or thoughts of the game video. What do I think about this DLC? Is it worth getting and playing. And I'll probably be back with the next DLC, which is in Czechoslovakia, and which will be released at the end of August somewhere. For now though, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.